Here's five receivers I'm going to bench this week heading into week 12. The first guy's Mike Evans. I know it might come as a surprise to people, but Evans, I just don't like it from this week. The last week, again, the touchdown saved his fantasy day, beasting into the end zone. Because if you don't get that touchdown, it's only a 5-catch-to-49-yard day. And that touchdown was amazing, running over defenders, all heart and will. But this week, he's got the Kansas City Chiefs that give up the third least amount of fantasy points to wide receivers. And like I said, Mike Evans, if you don't score those touchdowns, his fantasy points, they're not going to be there. And this week, I don't think he's going to find the end zone. You could like it or not, but I think Evans, he's going to have a tough day. Like I said, him and Brady, he is touchdown dependent, and you can't always get that touchdown each and every week. And we see that with guys. If they don't get their touchdown, the numbers go down. And for Mike Evans, that's definitely the case, because he hasn't cracked more than 70 yards in the last 5 weeks. So Mike Evans, he's a guy this week, I don't see him finding the end zone. And then he goes on bye in week 13, so I'm benching him. The next guy is T. Higgins. I'm benching him because it's not his fault. But Finley, a quarterback, I don't know what he's going to do. And we saw when Finley came in at the end of last week, Higgins didn't do much on his 10 targets. Only 3 catches for 26 yards. I said I liked Boyd as a starter, but this week I don't like Higgins as a starter. Him and Finley, I don't know if they got a rapport. Higgins, he's not that polished as a route runner as his teammate Tyler Boyd yet, but it is only his rookie year. But this week, I just don't see a great game for Higgins. I could only see him getting 10 to 12 fantasy points, a mediocre game, and I think there's better options to start than T. Higgins this week. If Joe Burrow was still in the lineup and not injured, Higgins is a guy you pretty much start each and every week. But this week versus a decent Giant defense, I'm putting him on the bench. The third guy's Jacoby Myers of the New England Patriots. Myers, he had a great few week run, but last week we saw him come back down to earth versus a weak Houston Texan defense, which I thought Myers would have a good game. He only finished with 3 catches, 38 yards. Now he versus Arizona here in week 7, and it wouldn't surprise me to see Patrick Peterson cover Myers in this one, because Julian Edelman, he's not coming back yet. Damir Bird and N'Keal Harry, they're back as well. Also, Damian Harris, he's getting 15, 20 carries a game, and James White, he's going to see more work out of the backfield with Burkhead out. So Myers, I just don't like how the game went for him last week. This week, I think Peterson's going to be on him, which is going to be a tough matchup. And Cam Newton, he's always been inconsistent of getting his receivers the ball. So this week I'm sitting Jacoby Myers on the bench. The fourth guy is Allen Robinson of the Chicago Bears. I know Robinson's the number one there. He's top 10, I believe, in fantasy points for wide receivers. But it's a matchup I don't like for him. He's going to have Jakeem Alexander on him, which is going to be a tough matchup. And who knows who his quarterback's going to be in week 10 versus a mediocre Minnesota team. Allen Robinson only had 6 catches for 43 yards. And in this game versus the Green Bay Packers, I could see a similar performance where it's an underwhelming performance and he only gets you 10 to 12 fantasy points. Because this Packer team, they're coming off a tough loss. You know they're going to look to take it out on the Bears and get to the quarterback early and often. And Jaire Alexander, he's a good corner, and I think he's going to lock down Robinson in this one. So I'm going to bench him if I don't have better options. And the fifth and final guy is DJ Chark of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Chark, he hasn't been doing much this season. And now another quarterback in Mike Glennon coming in for the Jacksonville Jaguars here this week. I know they versed the Cleveland Browns, who are pretty good. Denzel Ward, he'll probably cover DJ Chark. Chark now in his last 2 games, horrible performances for the most part. Week 10, 4 catches, 56 yards. And then last week versus a good Pitt team versus the Steelers, 4 catches, 41 yards. And this game versus Cleveland, I could see a similar type of stat line for DJ Chark where he's only going to get you 8 to 9 points. And that's not going to be a big impact. I don't think he's going to do much. And there's better options this season. Chark, he's just been a disappointment this fantasy season with only 5 games over double-digit fantasy points. And that's in PPR leagues. So DJ Chark, I'm staying away from him, and I'm benching him this week. So that's 5 wide receivers that are heading to the bench for me here, heading into week 12.